country. And yes, what I did find on this trip is that it's not just the educated women in urban places were able to take advantage of the opportunities provided by the last 20 years of international engagement. We went to a remote corner, one of the Ghor province in the central highlands of Afghanistan, and sitting around with tribal elders, and all of a sudden there's this extraordinary and illiterate woman who hasn't been allowed to be educated, that there are no schools for her daughter who's in the 12th class. I wish I could go to school, and I wish I could be a doctor, to which of course this provoked a wave of laughter from the men around the room, thinking that she was making a joke of it. And then she went on to say, looked at me, seeing me sitting with all the women moving through the village, and saying, look at you, and I'm just a prisoner, she said, in my home. So when the lobsters decided, we actually had a serious conversation about what is, even before the traditional conservative society, and we heard from the tribal elders, the men saying, this is about Pakistan and Iran, our neighbors, they are making progress. How the Iranians, why isn't all the time to help us to move forward for men and women. These are your reflections live from Kabul. Thank you very much. Our Chief International Correspondent. To Kenya now, where William Ruto has been declared the winner of the presidential